Hello everyone and welcome to Ian's Bricks. I'm Ian and today I want to discuss about the Lego Helmets and Cowls. These are basically sets that Lego started releasing in 2020 and they're sort of normally heads or busts of sort of famous or iconic heads and helmets and cowls, masks and things like that that Lego started doing for things like basically Batman and Star Wars and Iron Man and all the Marvel and superheroes films. So they appear to be very, very popular. And they've got quite a few on the market at the moment. These aren't all of them, but what these are the ones that have either retired. These three here have all retired from general release. And these five here will all be retiring at the end of 2022. So my question is it a good idea to be investing in Lego helmets? Because they are quite popular. A lot of people are talking about them. They've got a reasonably high sort of value as well. I mean, most of these sets retailed in the UK at least at £55. I think there's only the Scout Trooper helmet here, this one here in the middle, which is slightly smaller piece count, and that actually retails in the UK at £45. So they've got a reasonable value, but they are very, very collectible. They all have sort of printed pieces here, and I think people, they're just sort of nice to display. They are designed for adults. They are sort of 18 plus sets as well, so that sort of goes for the sets as well. What I want to do first of all is have a look at the original three sets here that have all retired, see how sort of the value of those sets are now on eBay and Amazon and all this kind of stuff. So let's have a look and see how much all of these items originally cost and what they're worth now. Here we have the three helmets that have already retired. So we'll start from the Iron Man on the left hand side. So the Iron Man set number 76165. This was actually released in the August of 2020 and retired in the December of 2021. So only about a year and a half shelf life, so not particularly long. This retailed in the UK at £54.99. I only have one of these. I actually bought this though for £39.58 on Amazon, so I actually got this at a discounted rate. On Amazon in the UK, you can still buy this. I think it's through a second party seller though, and that's currently at £124. I've also checked the eBay listings for the sold eBay listings for new sets, and they're coming through at around about £90 to £100. And I do remember at the time that the Iron Man helmet wasn't particularly well received. A lot of people didn't like how the mouth of the helmet looked. And I say I only bought one of these because I wasn't particularly sold it would do that well. How wrong could I be? The set in the middle is the Stormtrooper helmet. That's set number 75276. That has a shelf life. It was released in April of 2020 and retired in December of 2021. So just over a year and a half shelf life. So not particularly long. That retailed in the UK at £54.99. I actually managed to get my two copies for £33.77 off Amazon. So I got a huge discount, almost more than £20 off. So big discount when I actually purchased these. I think it was around about Black Friday, actually, maybe before. Anyway. So currently on Amazon there is one on sale, and that is going for £110 in the UK. Again, that's a sort of a brand new sealed set. And on eBay, these tend to go for sold, again, sealed, at around about £90 to £95. So, again, you know, not quite doubled in price from the recommended retail price, but certainly the price that I bought them at, they're certainly more than doubled in price, which is fabulous. And, of course, the best one, the Holy Grail, the one that everybody wants, it's the TIE Fighter Pilot Helmet. That's set number 75274. That's the one on the right-hand side of my display here. So again, that had a recommended retail price in the UK of £54.99. The shelf life, again, same as a Stormtrooper, released in April 2020. I think it was the first wave, this one, when they started doing helmets, April 2020, and that retired in December of 2021. So again, just over a year and a half shelf life. I actually had to pay full price for these from the Lego store because they weren't available in the UK. UK on Amazon or anywhere else from what I remember. So, and again, in, even in Lego.com and Lego stores, they were very, very difficult to get hold of at the time. So I'm really glad I managed to get two of these when they were available for sale. Currently in the UK, these are retailing at a couple of different sellers on Amazon in the UK at between £225 and £240 in the UK. I mean, that's a huge increase. And I think similar increases are being seen, you know, in the US and Europe and other places as well. These are very, very sought after. eBay sold prices are lower, obviously, because you know, Amazon has a sort of slight premium. So eBay listings are between, for sold items, sealed sold, are between £140 and £170. But even that is pretty much triple what the recommended retail price was on these particular sets. And don't forget, all of these sets have only been retired since December of 2021. So you're looking at, what, 8-9 months of them being officially retired. So that's not very long at all. Let's talk about the five helmets that are due to retire then at the end of 2022. So these are the five sets here. We have Carnage, the Star Wars Scout Trooper helmet, Boba Fett helmet, and the two Batman cowls, the DC Batman one and the classic TV series Batman cowl. These are all due to retire potentially at the end of 2022. I don't think this information has come directly from Lego.com, but from a good source on the internet, which is a company called Brick Fanatics. They have a good internet page which sort of normally lists all the sets that are due to retire. So, you know, you may get one of these perhaps that might not retire, but at the moment, as things stand in August 2022, all of these are due to retire at the end of the year. All of the sets are valued in the UK at least at £55, apart from the Scout Trooper helmet, which is £45. That's the recommended retail price for those. So if I talk through each one of them and sort of give my opinions. So firstly is the Carnage. Now this, I think this will do quite well. In the UK at least, it's reasonably hard to get rid of. It is available from Lego and I think maybe somewhere else, maybe Argos. I can't remember exactly where. I don't think people have been sort of hoarding these as much as some of the other helmets, like Boba Fett, for example, which we'll talk about in a bit. But it's got a relatively short shelf life. Let me just check my notes. So I think this particular set was released in May of 2021. So it's going to have just over a year and a half shelf life, so not particularly long. You do get quite a few stickers with this set, which may put people off a little bit. But I think in general, I think it should be quite a good set to invest in. I've certainly started to realise that I haven't got enough of these and I've started to buy a few of them. I think there are limits on Lego.com on how many of these you can buy. I think it's 5 at the moment. I might be wrong. So again, I think this will probably do okay. Again, I don't think we're talking some of the values, say like the TIE Fighter helmet. I don't think it's going to do that well, but compared to the other two, which were sort of mixedly received at the time, I think it should do okay. Now, I'm not saying that they will more than double in price in a year. That might not happen and probably won't. But certainly, I think for a reasonable time for Lego investing, if you hang on to it for between 1, 2, 3 years perhaps, I think you should get a good return on investment on that particular set. The next one then I look at is the Scout Trooper. So this is probably one of the least favoured of all of the sets that are going to be retired at the end of this year. I just don't think it's been very popular. People don't really like how it looks. It's also a bit smaller, but then it is cheaper as well. I do know that this is available in the UK on Amazon, and probably a lot of people have bought these in the past. They're normally discounted. I think I've seen them as low as sort of just over £30 in the UK. So if you could get it at that price, that's a very, very good price. But even though this isn't a particularly popular set, and again, it won't do as well as probably these particular helmets here, I still think it's got a bit of leeway in it to do reasonably well. Again, you'll probably need to wait a couple of years to get maybe make it double in price. I mean, who knows? It depends how the market is. But I think because people aren't maybe quite that into it, it's not going to be as popular. So you're not going to make huge returns on this one. But as I say, you know, I was thinking the same thing about Iron Man. People didn't really like it. I wasn't sure about it. It was regularly on Amazon, heavily discounted as well at a lower price. And look what it's doing now. So, you know, who knows? I might be completely wrong, but it should still do okay. Then we have the Boba Fett helmet. Now, this is a tricky one to try and guess how this is going to go, because this is a set that's been out, been released for over 2.5 years now. So a lot longer than any of the other helmets that are available. Price point of £55 in the UK. But again, this has been heavily, heavily discounted. I think I've picked a couple of these up for just over £30. So, you know, in the past, you've been able to get these at a very good price. So whether this one will do as well, because maybe a lot of people have got these and are hanging on to these thinking they'll do really, really well. And because it's Boba Fett as well, I think a lot of people have sort of hoarded these. And so you might find that this is a lot slower to increase in value as maybe some of the other sets. But who knows? Boba Fett is such an iconic character, such a, you know, people like it, people want it. And as soon as this goes out of stock, you know, why wouldn't it do as well as some of these other sets? I mean, again, we're not talking TIE fighter levels here, but, you know, why wouldn't it do okay? Why wouldn't it do well? So difficult one to gauge this one and how well this will do, just because of how long it's been out, how often it's been discounted, and maybe how many people have already bought these. So we'll have to wait and see on that one. But again, I mean, it should still do okay. I mean, you're not gonna lose out, certainly, if you buy a couple of these now, even at retail price, in a year or two's time, you're probably still going to make a reasonable profit, so it should be okay. So the final two Batman cowls at the top here, you've got the DC one and you've got the classic TV series. Of the two of them, I think this Batman cowl here, the DC one, is probably not particularly popular. I know when this came out, I didn't particularly like it. I just thought it was a bit weird. You've got this sort of huge hole in the middle where the face goes, and I just didn't really like it. And again, I mean, I had similar feelings about the Iron Man. A lot of people didn't like that and the face and everything. So as to why this wouldn't do well on the secondary market, again, it's probably going to be less favourable. People maybe not go for it as much. But also, this has also been quite heavily discounted in the UK. Now, I've only recently picked one of these up. They retail at £55 in the UK. I think I got it from Amazon at £43. So not a bad discount. I did see somebody in a Tesco somewhere in the UK posted that their local supermarket Tesco was selling these at £27.50. Now, unfortunately, my Tesco isn't a very big Tesco, and they didn't have any of these. They never would have any of these. So I don't think I'm going to see any in my local area for that price. But if you can pick them up for that price, I'd say go for it. I mean, you're on to a winner. I mean, it's literally half price. So as to whether this will do particularly well, again, I think probably not as well as some of the other helmets. I think, you know, the Carnage will certainly, I think, do better than this particular Batman. I think this has got a better look to it. And also, it just, there's a few things not maybe going for it that I don't particularly like myself. So we'll have to wait and see again how that one does. But the other Batman one here, the classic TV cowl, again, it's got a similar feel where it's got sort of empty hollow feeling in the middle of it. But I think this will do better simply because, a couple of reasons, this is a lot harder to get. This isn't available in the UK on Amazon. I think it is available maybe at one or two places, maybe like Smith's Toys, I think, have it. And I think they've had it recently reduced as well at £45 as opposed to £55. So there are some reductions to be had, but it's not that widely available. I know on Lego.com I had a look recently and they had a limit of two. So they are limiting people on how many of these they buy. So, you know, again, if you're in a different country, check your local sort of Lego stores and Lego.com listings to see how the limit on the number that you can buy is, because that may have a significance of how well these do in the future, because if people can only buy two, it's a lot more difficult for people to hoard them and get lots of them. Also, I think a thing that goes for this, certainly in the UK, maybe Australia and Canada and the US, is that the TV show, the classic TV show with Adam West, was probably a lot more widely available. You know, obviously being in English, being from the 60s, it was shown on TV throughout the 70s and 80s and probably is still on there somewhere now. It's very corny when you watch it now. It's all very dated, but it's all sort of good-humoured and whatever. So I think because maybe that TV show was a lot more popular, I would assume so, in English-speaking countries, because, you know, obviously that, you know, makes a bit more sense. It may be more popular as opposed to somewhere maybe like Europe. I mean, I don't know, in different countries like, you know, Germany or France or Denmark, whether or not that show was particularly popular. It might not have been. People might not know about it, which is why, if you're living in one of those countries, that it might not be such a good buy, because it's not that a popular thing. But certainly in the UK, I think the TV series sort of has a sort of a lasting appeal as such, and I think this will probably do better than the other Batman cowl, simply because it's more difficult to get hold of. I think it's got a much shorter shelf life as well. So this Batman here was released in April of 2021, and the classic cowl was released in October of 2021. So you've sort of got, you know, it's a lot less time this has been on the shelves, and people probably haven't particularly, you know, noticed this one. I have to say, I only noticed it recently. I wasn't really, you know, didn't really look. Hadn't noticed it hadn't been on Amazon. And so that's why I probably sort of missed out on that one myself. But I'm aware of it now, and I've certainly got a couple for my collection as well. And even if you're not buying for Lego investing, even if you're just buying for yourself, if you like this kind of things, get one now, because you'll probably regret it if you don't buy one and then you get 6 months or a year down the line and it's gone to the prices that the TIE Fi helmet has got. I mean, you're going to be very disappointed. You know, if you can get them now for recommended retail price or even lower, then you'll probably kick yourself. So if you do like this kind of thing, even if you're not into Lego investing, I think now is a very, very good time to look round to maybe, you know, buying some of these, because I think they're very, very nice. I haven't actually had the desire yet to open one and build one. I'd love to build them all, actually, but as I'm a Lego investor, I really, really try not to open things and not to build things, because otherwise you sort of devalue things when you open them. And I know you can open them and you can build them and you can sell them on when they're built as well, and they will still sell relatively well even after they've been built, but it does detract from the value. I think the difference in price from a sealed set to a set that's been built and opened, as long as you've got the box and everything still, you're losing about 40% on average. So yeah, it's always best if you can to try and keep these sets sealed. Anyway, I really, really like these helmets. I think for a Lego investor, I think these will do really, really well. As to whether these five here will do as well as these three, only time will tell. But I don't see why they wouldn't do, you know, nearly as well, certainly as the Iron Man helmet and the Stormtrooper helmet, which were reasonably readily available and available on discounts. There's no reason to say that these five wouldn't do, you know, as well as that, you know, and in such a short space of time, you know, literally in 9 months from when these retired, the prices of these have absolutely skyrocketed. So hopefully these will do the same, but we'll have to wait and see. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed my thoughts on this. Please do take all these advice and comments with a pinch of salt as well. There are lots of different factors as to whether things would go up in value. They might not retire, for example. Maybe people have maybe already invested and bought a lot of these, so it's going to take longer to appreciate in value because there's so many more of these out there, because people know that these have done well. And I know me making a video on helmets and things isn't probably going to help things, but my channel's relatively small so far, and you know, I don't have too many viewers and subscribers, so there probably, you know, there probably won't be too many people watching this. So it's not as though me making a video on this is suddenly gonna, thousands and hundreds of thousands of people are suddenly gonna start buying Lego helmets, because not that many people watch my videos yet. So fingers crossed that maybe more people do. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed my thoughts as well. And thank you very much for watching, as always. I might do a few more videos like this on different kind of themes and things, so watch out for those in the near future. But for now, thanks for watching. Until the next video, take care. See you then.